Now we'll see one question which is asked in GATE 2004 paper. Let me read the question. What is the result of evaluating the following expressions using 3-digit floating point arithmetic? Already I explained you what is 3-digit floating point, right? Arithmetic with rounding. So here the main concern is rounding. How you can understand rounding? Okay. So since it is a 3-digit floating point numbers, then we can write them like this, right? So there will be 3 significant digits. 113 is nothing but 1.13 into 10 to the power of 2, right? This is a model. Now minus 111 is nothing but minus 1.11 into 10 to the power of 2. So first we have to do subtraction, correct? So when I do subtraction, base is equal, see exponents are equal, then directly we have to subtract the mantissas. So here mantissa is 1.13, 1.11. Let us do the subtraction. 3 minus 1, 2, 1 minus 1, 0. Okay, so 1 minus 1, 0. So you got 0.02 into 10 to the power of 2. So here, so you don't need extra god digits, correct? Because so we know the numbers were representable in 3 digits. If you have a number which cannot be representable in 3 digits but representable in more digits, we have to use god digits, correct? So here god bits are not required at this moment. So and one more thing, it is not IEEE 754 format, so number of god digits are not mentioned, so we can take any number of god digits. That is what we can understand from the question. So finally I got 0.02 into 10 square. Keep this as it is. Now 7.51. How to write 7.51 in floating point numbers like this? So 7.51 into 10 to the power of 0, isn't it? Now we need addition. How to do addition of floating point? First of all, base should be equal, right? That means exponent should be equal. So when I equate exponents, this 10 power 0 should make 10 square. For that I have to shift mantissa to right side. So let's do that. 0.02 into 10 square. Now we got experience. Already we did, right? 0.0751, right? I am assuming that I have enough number of god digits. So of course, even if you assume that it is IEEE problem, that means the question is about IEEE 754 format, still two god digits we have. That means we are not losing any information. So let us do the simplification. 0.02, because it is addition, 0.0200, 0.0751, 1, 5, 2 plus 7, 9, so you get 0.0951, right? So into 10 square. Now this is a time to rounding, correct? We have only 3 significant digits, 1, 2, 3, then 51. Remember one thing, already I explained you in rounding, when you are discarding the digits, out of them, 5 is the first digit. Then since it is greater than or equal to 5, then according to our rounding methods, so when it is more than or equal to 5, what to do? We have to remove that digits 51 and we have to add what? Plus 1 here, right? So 0.09, for that we have to add 0.01. So 1 plus 9, 10, you get 1 here, 1 here, so 0.10. Finally, answer would become 0.10, this one's answer. 0.10 into 10 to the power of 2. That is nothing but 10. So finally, option B, otherwise option D is the right choice. Now we will see the second calculation to understand what is the correct answer. Now we'll see second one. So again, same way we write it. 113 is 1.13 into 10 squared. Minus 111 is minus 1.11 into 10 squared. 7.51. In 3 digits, we write like this, 7.51 into 10 to the power of 0, right? So these are the floating point representations. First, we do this one, 7.51 plus minus 111. End of the day, what happens? Subtraction, right? Subtraction from, I mean, we have to subtract 111 from 7.51, correct? Example, when you have minus 5 plus 10, what you do? Then we subtract bigger number, smaller number from bigger number, right? In the same way here also, same thing. Example, if you have minus 11 plus 9, what you do? Subtract first 11 and 9, then put this negative symbol to answer, correct? Same thing we are going to do now. Subtract 111 from 7.51 first. Let us do that. Minus 1.11, of course, minus we can put later. So So 1.11 into 10 square. Second one is 7.51 into 10 to the power of 0. The first immediate step is shifting the mantissa because we have to make these exponents equal. So if I do that, I get 1.1100 because when you are shifting two digits, then we have to have two extra positions. Otherwise, guard digits. 7.5100 will become, 0.0751 into 10 square. Already we had enough experience, correct? So now subtraction is easy. 10 square, same. Now let us do subtraction, decimal subtraction. 10. 10 minus 1, 9. This is 9. 9 minus 5, 4. So this will become what? 0. So 0 minus 7, for that again borrow. 10 minus 7, 3. Then it will become 0. Then it will become 1. 1.0349 into 10 square, correct? That is the answer. And of course minus, because end of the day we have to keep minus because 111 is bigger than 7.51. Once it is done, what we are going to do? We are going to do rounding. This entire concept is about rounding. How to do rounding? Recall, whenever you have, you know, this 49 to be discarded, correct? In the discarded bits, 4 is greater than, less than 5, right? When you have a less than 5 numbers, truncation will take place. So we do truncation. You get 1.03 into 10 square. That is nothing but 103, correct? Now, let's keep 1.03 into 10 square as it is. Now we have to add 113, correct? So let us do that. Of course, symbol is minus, right? I am writing 113, which is nothing but 1.13 into 10 square. Again, same thing, subtraction. Let us do subtraction between this 1.13 into 10 square and 1.03 into 10 square. Simple. Exponents are equal, directly subtraction. 3 minus 3, 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 0.10 into 0.10 into 10 square. So here, 0.10 into 10 square is nothing but 10, correct? Yes. So answer is 10.0 and 10.0. This is wrong, right? In that way, easily we can solve this problem, not a problem, correct? So blindly follow the rules, right? Here you should know how rounding takes place. That's it. If you understand that, it is pretty clear.